Playboy. Okay guys, so starting out, the first thing I always do even before I do my brows is I prep my skin.
Really quick guys, I just want to apologize for the noise in the background. This was originally going to be a voiceover, but at the last minute I switched it up and forgot to turn off the fan. So I'm really sorry for the noise you hear in the back.
And sometimes that can get in your brows, and when you start to do them, they're really slippery and everything just goes on really messy and it's just not good, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my very dirty makeup rag and I'm going to wipe away any product that may have gotten in my brows while I was prepping my skin. So now I'm going to go into a pencil, and I'm using this Wet n Wild Color Icon Brow Pencil, and I'm going to start outlining my brow. So I'm going to start at the tail and draw a line, and I'm going to extend my brow because it ends right there and I like my brows a little bit longer, but it's up to you. And then I'm going to start in the middle right there and draw a line connecting it to the one that I just made. If y'all can see that, okay? I got y'all zoomed in real close and uncomfortable, okay? So hopefully y'all can see. And now I'm going to start at the very beginning of my brow and draw a third line connecting to the one I just made. Real easy, real simple. Now I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. Okay, so we have the bottom outlined. Now we're going to start at the top. So again, I'm going to start at the end, about right here, and I'm going to draw a line connecting it to the bottom. And I wanted it a little bit darker, so I'm going to do it just like that. And then the same thing, draw some lines connecting it to the one you just made. And when I'm doing the line at the front, I'm not going to take it all the way out because that's going to give you a really boxy brow. So I'm going to end it about right here, if you can see that. So my brow starts right here. I ended the line right there. Same thing on the other side. Drawing a line, connecting it to the bottom. Then draw another line, connecting it to the one we just made. And stopping it about a third of the way from the beginning of the brow. Okay, so now that the brows are all outlined, I'm gonna go in with a cream, and I'm using the e.l.f. Lock On Liner and Brow Cream in Espresso, and it cost me about $2 or $3 at Walmart. You can use whatever you want. You can use a gel, a cream, what else is there? A pomade, whatever works for you. And then I'm gonna go in with this Morphe dual-sided eyebrow brush. So it has a brush on one side and a spoolie on the other. And what I'm gonna do here, this is one of my little tricks or whatever. I think it's a trick of mine. I'm going to dip into the product, just like that. And then I'm gonna take my brush and I'm gonna pinch it so it's more firm and more thin. And that's gonna help with making your brows very precise. So I'm taking this and I'm starting at the tail end of my brow because you don't want your brow to be dark all the way. You want it to gradually fade to the darkness. So starting at the tail end, and then I'm gonna work my way up to the front. This way, and I'm gonna start going like this to the hands. And then I'm not gonna dip back in. I'm kind of gonna wipe it off on my hand a little bit and then use whatever's left to fill in the front. So we're gonna take it again like this and just flick up. like that. And it probably looks real crazy, but we're not done yet, okay? So I'm just gonna do the same thing to the other eye. Every couple steps, just go ahead and use your spoolie to spoolie them out. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to conceal my brows, and for this I'm going to be using my NYX Conceal and Correct palette. I'm going to be taking this shade right here for the bottom, and then I'm going to use this shade for the top because it's a little bit closer to my actual skin tone. So if you can see, I'm kind of starting right here and then working my way up towards the brow, because you don't want the bulk of the product to be right at the edge of your brow, because then it's gonna look real, I don't even know the word, it's just not gonna look right, okay? So you're gonna start a little bit away from it and then work your way up. Again, and I'm just gonna fill in any sparse areas that we have, and I'm gonna fill in around the edges. Really gives you a smoother look. So today I'm going to be using the e.l.f. Flawless Concealer Brush. Now I'm blending out the bottom, and I'm going to blend going down like this. Lightly brush through the front. honestly, you don't really have to go out and buy those super expensive brow gels. This is the e.l.f. Eyelash and Eyebrow Gel. It's dual-sided, and it costs $1, like literally $1 at Walmart, and it works really, really good. When I use this, my brows stay put in place all day. So these are the brows with a whole full face. I had to go and do a full face makeup just so you guys could really get a feel of how they look. If you are interested in seeing how I got this look, stay tuned. A video for this will be coming very, very, very soon. But as far as this video, if you enjoyed it or if you learned something from me, don't forget to go ahead and like and share and subscribe and comment. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye!